Hey, I'm Noah, and for the past 2 years, my father Vincent and I have taken a deep dive into world events, religion, the spiritual world, and most importantly, Jesus Christ. Come explore these topics with us as we discuss our journeys and what led us on our journeys to begin with. In this podcast, we will attempt to open a can of worms and inevitably open 10 in the process. We hope to be informative, encourage you on your exploration, and share with you the same hope that we have come to know and love. So without further ado, this is Jacob's Ladder, the podcast. So we're back again, and we had to hurry up and press the record button because we already got started talking, and then we realized we are getting a little bit ahead of ourselves. But yeah. So what were you just talking to me about?
Well, I think it's interesting the paths that we have taken as far as finding out truth in connection with the Bible. And it's actually kind of funny how your search for truth and for God actually started off as with Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
You know, you left the watchtower.
I was searching for Jesus, basically. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So instead of me talking for you, why don't you just explain what did you find in your search for Jesus?
Well, I think it was easy to accept Jesus right off the bat. I actually accepted Jesus without giving it much thought. Mm-hmm. I mean, I accepted the one God, Yahweh, which I accepted as like the ancient God, the real one. And then I guess through that, I saw Jesus as being the truth. And so that never really was a something that I had a problem with. But later on in my search, you know, if Jesus is the truth, when I started studying into the occult philosophies, the theosophy or the like Freemasonry stuff, I kept coming across this idea of a spirit of Christ, and this is a Gnostic idea, basically. Mm-hmm. So the idea that Jesus was not an actual fleshly being or anything like that, but rather he was just a man that had awakened himself to this, what they would call Christ consciousness. So any one person could awaken themselves to this Christ consciousness, and that Jesus was just an esoteric or like a symbolic theme or figure that was like basically telling this story of how we were supposed to like achieve this oneness with God through an esoteric Jesus. So then I found myself really questioning the idea of so Jesus is the truth, but did he come in the flesh, or was he just a kind of a thing in the matrix, if you will, like some sort of
yeah, I remember
thought talking, or concept that we were trying to achieve.
Yeah, we were talking about that another time, how there was a scripture you came across.
In 1 John. That if anyone, you know, says that Jesus Christ did not come in the flesh, that is the Antichrist. So, so that certainly, you know, down that road, there was just something that didn't sit right. And then after reading that, it was who you believe.
I remember it was a quick fix for you.
Yeah.
As soon as you found that scripture, that's when you called me.
Yeah.
And you made that. And it was the same for me.
Yeah.
When you read that scripture, I'm like, that's a done deal.
Yeah.
You know, the esoteric Jesus is actually, and this is what I recently have come to the conclusion about, and this is why I wanted to talk about this a little bit, is that Satan does everything to deceive people.
Yeah.
He puts all of these religions out there. So people are like trying to find the true religion. You have all of these gods out there. People are trying to find the real God. you know, who's really the creator, who, you know, what's his name, all of this. So it's very confusing for people. But what you find is, once you find the true God,
yeah,
and who he is, and you find Jesus, mm-hmm. you would think it would be the end.
Yeah. Yeah.
But then at the bottom of the rabbit hole, Satan wants to take you away.
Yeah.
Because now you are so close
yeah.
to the real Jesus.
Yeah.
So he would love to take you to the Gnostic. You know,
yeah. Which is funny because, like, for it to say, for the Bible to say that the message of the Antichrist is that Jesus Christ did not come in the flesh. Like, there are many Antichrist ideas out there. Mm-hmm. But for that to be the one signifier of it is a very interesting thing, because these people all believe in a concept Jesus Christ. They all believe in a spirit of Christ, but they do not believe in the flesh of Jesus.
And that's interesting that you said that, because I want to talk about that, but I can't get there yet. And that is, you identified the Antichrist.
Mm-hmm.
And the Bible makes a big deal about the Antichrist.
Yeah.
And the true Antichrist is in, it's found in theosophy.
Yeah.
Which is connected to Freemasonry. Which is, exactly.
Kabbalah.
So that is the Antichrist, or where its origin comes from.
And which that's the New Age movement. That's what the New Age, and everyone is doing New Age nowadays. Mm-hmm. Yeah. But you see that this is on the rise right now. That's because the Antichrist is rising. Like and that's just a manifestation of the real Antichrist. But
I just find that very interesting because you have that, but then when people study government, you find, and again,
you find these themes showing up again and again.
Yeah. Everything is based in theosophy.
Yeah.
The United Nations. You know, we talked about the Lucis Trust, which is all United Nations. Everything is owned pretty much by the same groups of religious people that teach theosophy.
Yeah.
So your search, it ended quickly with that scripture.
Mm-hmm.
And it basically, it prevented me from even going the opposite. I mean, when you read that scripture to me, I'm like, oh, done deal. I don't even have to consider the esoteric Jesus.
Yeah.
Because I was simultaneously, while you were doing this thing, I was learning the same stuff from that Mark Passio guy.
I think what stopped me too, and I said this in the last podcast, but the idea that as soon as I heard that, all those things started clicking inside of my head, like, you know, the wisdom thing, that God hides these things from the wise and he gives them to little children. So I'm thinking about how much I was taking, like I was cherishing basically this idea of having hidden wisdom. And I thought, like, is having hidden wisdom something that God is going to be, smiling upon? Is he going to love that you have this hidden wisdom?
Yeah.
Or is he going to view this as a prideful thing? And in the end, I had to really when I saw that scripture, I knew what it was.
I remember early on when you first started calling me, it's when your views of God and the Bible and everything were changing. I remember how different that conversation was.
Yeah.
Because it had to do with having knowledge of secret things.
Yeah.
And now I see you today, and it's totally different.
Yeah.
Now it's like, I don't know anything at all.
Yeah.
True. Yeah. So you stopped me from even considering the esoteric. I mean, I'm not saying it never crossed my mind, because if you're listening to podcasts, there are ones that truly believe this. They totally believe in Christ, but it's the esoteric Christ, a higher level of consciousness. Totally. Yeah. They believe theosophy has truth in it.
Yeah.
They believe it is true, period. Yeah. This is why I found it interesting, is that you went down that hole, and here you have the two Jesus. You have the literal Jesus and the esoteric Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
But remember what my problem was?
Yeah.
I was into Spiritism.
Yeah.
Yeah. So...
So tell me about, like, what is relatable with my story, but with your story.
Well, that is what's funny. You were in search for Christ. Mm-hmm. I literally went in search for the devil.
Yes. Yeah.
Like, literally.
Yeah.
Because I was involved in... I say involved. It's not like I was going to seances or anything like that. Yeah. I just had a fascination with dark mysteries and all of this. And I, as I said before, I viewed Satan more like symbolic of the unknown.
Yeah.
You know, evil, whatever. So in my search, you know, I received a phone call where someone was saying, talking to me about, you know, what's going on in the world. Mm-hmm. And without going into detail, it was easy for me to see how, you know, as a Jehovah's Witness or any other religion, when they talk about Satan ruling the world, you just have this hodgepodge of an idea of what that means.
Yeah, yeah. So you're just thinking, like, just a basic idea that, like, people are bad, mm-hmm. and Satan caused it somehow.
Yeah,
so, like, he's like, just... people are, like, people are tempted by Satan, yeah. people are... perverted by Satan.
So Satan's just throwing out that porn magazine, so yeah. or, you know, internet site, and,
yeah.
you know, and then he's causing wars, but you don't know how, and yeah. just, it actually becomes unbelievable.
Yeah.
You can't, you know, prove that.
Yeah.
It's just something you believe, right? But then what I learned, as I was learning this, and I've said it before, and I'll keep going back to Ephesians, how Paul said, you know, we have a war, yeah. not against blood and flesh, but against government
yeah.
and wicked spirit forces in heavenly places. But he's not talking about the actual physical government. He's talking about, well, yeah. there is a connection. Yeah, but there yeah. is a connection between the spirit world and government, and that's yes. what he is saying. So I started going down this rabbit hole, and I began to realize that most of the wickedness that we see, all of the major issues on Earth are caused, well, it's a organized chaos.
Yeah.
You know, that's what we see. It's an organized chaos. Most of it is very orchestrated. You know, I've said before, you know, you just study World War I, II, all of your major wars of the world, and you find that it's not what we thought.
Yeah.
You know, there's powerful organizations behind these things, making things happen. That's how we had our, like, the Industrial Revolution. It didn't come by.
Yeah, and you see these, and you see a lot of these, like, clubs. And like, that's the thing is, some of the stuff is just stuff that it's, there's so much evidence to point you in that direction, like, that people may say, like, oh, you don't have proof, but you have so much evidence mm-hmm. in this area, like, you know, for example, like the atomic bomb, like the first, okay. like the first time they talk about these things is at Bohemian Grove. There's a whole entire meeting addressed to the whole Manhattan Project, everything to do with that before it even happened. And this is provable, is like, you know, you have these clubs, you have the Trilateral Commission, you have mm-hmm. the Bohemian Club, you have, you know, these secret societies. And there's evidence that these people, I mean, we know they're powerful people. Mm-hmm. And then, well, they talk about these things before they happen. It's all
in
main,
people don't understand that this stuff is in mainstream
yeah.
media, but not the mainstream media like CNN or NBC. Mm-hmm. But you can go directly to websites.
Yeah.
You know, like, just like I said, the World Economic Forum, you know, the Lucis Trust, they tell you what the foundation is of what yeah. they believe in. They tell you what they're going to do. They tell you what they plan on doing. So it's all out there.
Yeah.
You know, I remember listening, you mentioned Bohemian Grove. I remember I listened to a very detailed historical, you know, podcast about Bohemian Grove.
Yeah.
Who went there,
yeah.
what they do, how they got in, just all sorts of things. It's all provable because it's just facts. See, that's what is hard now to help people to see. It doesn't matter if you personally understand how something can happen or why it's happening.
Yeah.
Sometimes you just have to face the fact that a truth is a truth.
Yeah,
it might lead yeah. you to other answers. For example, I don't want to get into 9/11, but I'm going to mention it, though, because I think it's a very good example. It just illustrates my point. The plane
yeah.
in Pennsylvania.
Yeah.
There was no plane.
Flight 99, yeah.
that's a fact. Yeah. There was just a hole in the ground, and we are given the story that it dissolved.
Yeah, it's kind of like the one that hit the Pentagon. Well, yeah. Hit in quotes, mm-hmm. hit the Pentagon. There's no
evidence of a plane.
There's a lot of missing pieces from that whole mm-hmm. thing. Yes. There's no videos. There's
nothing. People didn't. They don't report of anything. Yeah. Seeing anything. I know. So why not just accept the facts as they are? So even if you don't know all the answers, we live in a strange world.
Well, it's
a strange world of lies.
You know, I mean, I don't know why it reminds me, but, you know, we're talking now. What is this? This is 2021. So, mm-hmm. but we, you know, I remember talking to you when I first found out about Bohemian Grove. And
yeah, you were talking to me about Bohemian Grove.
I mean, I was
Grove
in middle
when
school.
When you were in middle school, and I remember, I thought, well, that's just crazy stuff. I didn't really doubt you, but I had no idea. I was like any typical American
yeah.
or typical Western person.
You're like, well, what am I supposed to do with this information?
Almost? Exactly. I mean, you showed me the videos of how Molech is there. And
yeah.
They're burning fire. And,
yeah.
You know, it's proof. You just got to look in Wikipedia.
Yeah.
It tells you that all these people go there.
Yeah.
You know, the presidents, the captains of industry, all this stuff. And I remember that. I'm like, well, that's just weird.
Yeah.
They're burning a doll.
And you know it's
on
you
Molech's
know,
feet.
You know it's occultic, and you know it's bad, but you don't know where it fits into the larger puzzle.
No. And that's where people don't ask themselves why.
Yeah.
They just say, oh, that's weird. Just like I did. I'm yeah. like, oh, that's just really weird. Yeah, there's a lot of stuff in the world we don't understand.
Yeah.
It's not normal for presidents, world leaders, you know, Bill Gates and all these guys to go down there and burn
there's a
baby doll at the feet of Molech dressed up in robes yeah. and calling it the cremation of care.
Yeah. I mean, there's a reason. There's a reason it's private. There's a reason it's hidden, mm-hmm. secret. People
yep.
don't, you know, they don't want you to take videos of it, obviously,
yep.
but they have.
Well, there is definitely a revealing. It's been a slow, but now it's a rapid revealing
yeah.
of what's going on.
And I guess that might have been a part of that whole thing, too, is that, you know, it has been a long time since you've known about Bohemian Grove.
Yeah, it had a deep impact on me. I just, you know, you just...
But there's an explosion of, like, information that's out there.
Yeah, right now.
I mean, like, without some of the things that are going on with, like, the World Economic Forum, with Agenda 21, mm-hmm. all these things, you may not have been able to put all the puzzle pieces together.
No.
So I think, like you're saying, like, some of these puzzle pieces have finally fallen in.
But, yeah, yeah, I think what you're saying is an excellent point, because when you started talking to me about Bohemian Grove, it still was just one of those things that, you know, you'd have to go really searching for it, hard
yeah.
to find, and you showed me some websites, you know, obscure
yeah.
websites about
and
the New World Order.
And some of them don't seem legit, so you're kind of like,
oh, honestly,
like, okay.
Back then, I mean, when you showed me that stuff then, I'm like, you know, it's weird because there is a pattern.
Yeah.
That these guys are showing, but I'm like, eh. I thought to myself, this is interesting. I'll keep it in the back of my mind.
Yeah.
But you just kind of forget about it. You don't really think about it. But now, within the last few years,
yeah,
it has, like you said, it has exploded. The amount of information that's being released, I mean, everywhere, concerning these kinds of things.
Yeah.
I mean, I listen to so many people, that are awake
yeah.
to these things. Even if they can't put it all together, they know something weird is going on
yeah,
in our
it's,
world.
Yeah, it's kind of like the Epstein thing. Like, you don't know... You don't have to know everything about it. In fact, like, all you need to know is that here's a powerful man who has connections to all these other powerful people, and he is, you know, gathering these young girls for... experiment. I mean, he's using them as sex slaves, sure,
yeah.
but like
he has an island.
He works in
Bill Gates has been with
in
him.
Biotech, so he's working with his company is transhumanism,
mm-hmm.
and then you have like all this stuff about the adrenochrome. I think that's
yeah, adrenochrome.
Coming out, and like these things are things that are put out there in the predictive programming. Mm-hmm. Not only that, but like you can see the pattern that these people are doing something even weirder than just even weirder than just sex slavery. This is ritualistic. Oh, yeah. Truth. It's occultism. Yes. It's, I mean, when you look at the stuff that's inside Epstein's apartment, you mm-hmm. see the pictures with the six fingers.
Yes.
You see the god statues and all mm-hmm. these things. I mean,
there's something bigger going on. I mean, this is not normal.
It's religious in nature.
Yes.
And that's what you can tell from it. So like people can just say like, yeah, he's a weirdo. He's more than a weirdo.
So it goes, everything you've mentioned, see all the things you highlighted. That's what I'm talking about when I say facts are facts. Mm-hmm. Forget about conspiracy. Yeah. You know, that word is just a way of, you know, just canceling everything and, you know, saying none of it's true. Facts are facts. Like everything you said, fact.
Yeah.
People don't ask themselves why. How does that connect to Bohemian Grove? It all does. And Bohemian Grove is just one secret place they meet and all of this. But people never ask why. Well, I started asking the question why. What's going on here? So I started researching all this stuff that you mentioned. And made everything come together for me is when I started studying the connections between, say, government, NASA, the United Nations, and the occult. When I started looking at how the United Nations has an occultic foundation, as we mm-hmm. said, the Lucis Trust.
Yeah.
And I wanted to know who's behind the United Nations.
Yeah.
It was pretty obvious. I mean, they tell you on the site it's theosophy.
Yeah.
It's what you stated. I mean,
this is just a side point, but it is weird that, like, I mean, as a witness, you were told the United Nations is evil. I mean, it's like,
that's don't even take me down the witness route now. Because
it's a bigger rabbit hole than we'd have to go down.
You know, but people don't understand that the Watchtower organization, now you got me going down this hole here. The Watchtower organization, there's so much going on with that, mm-hmm. more than you think. You think it's just this small religion, mm-hmm. you know, like Pentecostal or something. You just think it's a religion, right? They are so New World Order.
It's like a control group.
It
like,
is.
Well, like a test group.
For the New World Order.
Yeah, yeah.
I know. Because I always wondered, how does the Watchtower, and you just thought it was because they had connections with God, but the Watchtower always talked about the United Nations and how they're going to declare peace and security, and how they're going to be the ones that destroy religion. They even say that the United Nations is the image of the beast.
Yeah.
And they just talk a lot about the United Nations ever since we were, you know, since I was a baby. How do they know that?
Yeah.
Is it because they were smart? No. They have connections to Freemasonry, the New World Order, the occult, everything. And that's obvious. I mean, like I said before, you just look at some of Russell, the president of the society. Yeah. Look at his books.
Yeah.
Get Egyptian or symbology on it.
Yeah.
You know.
Or who he was funded by.
Funded by the Rothschilds, I believe. Yep. Yeah. Rockefellers, all that stuff. Which, again, these are names a lot of people know about.
Yeah.
They don't.
But they got their, like, we're going to get deep into it, apparently, but it's okay. It's okay. But I mean, like, if anyone didn't know, the Rockefellers and Rothschilds, you may hear that name. They're like American royalty. Mm-hmm. And many people just like, you know, we know that they have like Jewish roots. Mm-hmm. But who are these people? Why are they so important?
Yeah, what's the religion? What motivates them?
Where did they get their money? Mm-hmm. Well, these people are the ancestors of the Knights of Malta, mm-hmm. who were the Templar Knights.
Interesting.
And so the Templar Knights were knights that were put in service during the Crusades by the Catholic Church. And the Catholic Church basically they were moving people from Jerusalem to Rome, mm-hmm. and all over in between there. And the knights would basically first they started transporting people from each, you know, from each place. They mm-hmm. were there to protect people. And eventually it came to the point where, like, they were getting rich and they were carrying rich people's stuff. So what they instituted these banks. Mm-hmm. So a person could deposit their riches with the knights in one place in, like, Rome, and then go to Jerusalem and then acquire their riches there from them. So they didn't have to carry their riches on the road. Mm-hmm. So this is how the knights actually gained all this wealth and power, because they were a bank in themselves. And their order, they were the ones that were first found with the Baphomet, like, insignias and the all that stuff. And so, like, these people, I mean, this was during the Crusades. So this is where all this power and influence comes from, is from the Roman Catholic Church era, like, during their prime time of the mm-hmm. Crusades. This is where these families in America that are funding these things in the mm-hmm. early 1900s are still coming this yes. way. That's so it's a long time. It's been...
Well, and you mentioned the Catholic Church, and the information that I found, remember when I mentioned just now how I found a connection between government, NASA, and,
yeah.
and you know, the occult and all that, and the United Nations? Well, the Catholic Church mm-hmm. was another connection in there. Mm-hmm. It all connects. It's all the same. They're all working together. And so what I found is that, like, you know, you talked to me about the New World Order, Bohemian Grove, all that stuff, long yeah. time ago. But then when I, you know, as I got older and I started looking for God, actually, in order to believe in God, I wanted to see the devil, right? That's yeah. That's where I'm going with this. So I started, again, researching these things that we're talking about. And that is when I began to see, like, when Paul talks about a war not against blood and flesh, he is not talking about some, you know, haphazard way that Satan controls the world, like we were talking about evangelicals or yeah. the Watchtower. You know, Satan's not just out there, you know, throwing, like I said, a porn magazine at somebody.
Yeah.
You know, he has an organized system of government. Mm-hmm. He has actual boots on the ground that are carrying out his will. And that is what I began to see.
Yeah.
That there is, it's more than just a pattern. I mean, a pattern, you know, you could find a pattern if you find, like, a piece way over here and a piece way over there, and you can kind of create your own pattern, right?
Yeah.
I'm talking about, like, everything's a pattern. Mm-hmm. Everything. Everything from, like, you find out that the United Nations is owned by the same groups, by Zionists. I mean, well, it's a yeah. Zionist organization. Jesuits, all these, you know, religious groups. It's owned by that religion,
yeah.
which is based in theosophy. Mm-hmm. And then you have the Catholic Church, same thing. I mean, look at all of the occultic, esoteric things they have.
Yeah.
You know, I can't even go into
Well, there's yet. Like, you know, it's like if you look at St. Francis, who developed the... now, don't quote me on all this, because it's been a long time since I researched it, but, like, he was Illuminati. I mean, that's where the start was a Roman Catholic. Mm-hmm. And, like, the Rosicrucians, these are all, like, different sects that are yeah. teaching very similar doctrines. It's all the same, really. And that's mm-hmm. that's what we're getting at.
Yes.
Is that they are all the same. They may have these small differing viewpoints, mm-hmm. but it's more like the difference between, like, a Baptist and a Pentecostal. Yes. Like, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Like they have some similar doctrines, you know?
Yeah.
They have things that are different, but it's all, quote unquote, Christianity.
Yeah.
Considered that.
Yeah. And what yeah. is, and the bottom, at the bottom line, it is either God is God or you are God.
Because everything, the ones that own everything.
Yeah.
The United Nations, well, look at all the media owned by the Rockefeller,
yeah.
you know, foundation, all that. The educational system
yeah.
is all set up by the Rockefeller Foundation.
Yeah.
You know, everything we learn in school, they mm-hmm. have controlled it. All the media is the same. So who's behind it? What's motivating them? And then you find out, like you said, it's the same religion.
Yeah, yeah. And it's just this idea that we can do whatever we want because we mm-hmm. are... They, I mean, in their opinion, they are God. So
God exists, but not the way
yeah.
the Bible would teach it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So going back, why is, you know, why am I even mentioning this stuff? It's because I began to see all of these patterns. I seen what was behind all of these organizations, even Netflix. Oh, big time. That is controlled by the same groups.
And you can tell in hindsight when you look at the predictive programming with the, just the, like the certain, I mean, go on there, read the plots of the featured movies, mm-hmm. and you'll see these weird symbolic patterns that show up almost, I mean, all the time. Mm-hmm. All the time
yeah, they show up. Yeah, this is not something you have to go searching for. It is there.
It's like, why in recent years, in the last couple of years, have been there been movies like Clockwork Orange or Eyes Wide Shut or mm-hmm. like just these like these Stanley Kubrick movies that yeah. are like you know, you watch Eyes Wide Shut and then you read about Epstein.
And it's they, like, they release it like about
holy
close
crap.
To the same time when it's starting to be
yeah.
revealed. I know.
Yeah, and you're like, wow, this is what the movie is about.
Or like as soon as COVID came out, they started releasing or putting it in our face like Contagion.
Yeah, or
and
that
plus,
movie, what is it, Songbird?
Songbird.
Yeah.
And yeah, and that's a movie that came out shortly after COVID, and they're already talking about COVID, what, 23 or 20, I forgot.
Yeah.
COVID 24.
23,
I mean, they're
yeah.
stretching out the COVID, and they show people being pulled out of their homes and everything.
Yeah.
And that's, I know, you're getting me excited to talk about some of these other points, but even on the... when that movie starts, the picture that they show
yeah.
is the phoenix rising out of the ashes.
Yeah.
And people, you know, they watch the movie and they think, oh, this is funny.
It's the order out of the chaos.
Yeah,
the,
order out of chaos. It's the new world order
yeah.
arising. That's what it means. And so they're telling you these things, right, to your face. But what do people say? Oh, can you believe we're actually living a life like a movie? No. They've made...
The
they
movies
created
are patterned after reality.
Yes.
Because they know what...
They're telling you what's going to happen.
And when... And I guess to be... just to clarify, when... Because I don't know if you have a different idea of who they is
well,
than I
they.
Do. But I, so, I mean, like, you can give your opinion and I will
that's
give
funny.
My opinion
that's
of
funny
what
you say they.
Yeah.
Because even people that don't believe what we're saying now...
Yeah.
They always use the word they, too.
Yeah.
Like, they want us to believe this, or they want us to believe that. Or they'll say things like, well, you know, the president, he's just a puppet.
Yeah.
Puppet of what? Puppet
yeah.
of who?
Yeah.
You know, and people are always saying the word they.
Yeah.
But as soon as you talk about identifying they,
yeah.
oh, you're just a conspiracist.
Yeah.
You know, but that's understanding who they is.
Like, and how...
It's very important in connection with the Bible.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Because I would say that... And
I keep
you know,
saying
some,
they is.
Some,
I meant they are.
Some people some people would say that they is just these organizations. It's just Hollywood that's
mm-hmm.
trying to push this agenda
yeah,
on
but
you.
What's Hollywood?
Or, like, it's, you know, even if you're, like, a conspiracy theorist,
huh?
you may say, like... It's like Hollywood, but Hollywood is satanic, and they're in with these secret organizations. And that is true. To
mm-hmm.
some extent, I think that is true. But I believe that these are not things that people do purposefully. This is not something that...
that's where
these,
the greater... Yeah.
Like, I don't
Keep
believe
going.
That these plots... That these, like, I don't think anyone sits down, like, no director, producer, writer.
Yeah,
they sit down
yeah.
and they say, now we are going to make this movie and we're going to base it on what's about to happen in real life.
Mm-hmm.
No, I don't think that's how it is. I think it is a prophecy and that these people are prophesying in ways they did not know. I think they're prophecies inspired by demons most
mm-hmm.
of the time, and that these spirits, you know,
mm-hmm.
I mean, we think of spirits as like these almost people-like things,
yeah.
but they're not like that. And like, they are influencing these people, whether through the use of drugs or through their mm-hmm. own, like, inclinations.
Yeah.
They can influence these people yeah. to write these things mm-hmm. that reflect a pattern in reality. And I only say this from my own experience because there have been times that I've written songs
yeah.
that only in hindsight, years later, I could look back and say, that was a prophecy. I have prophesied something.
Mm-hmm.
And they were, like... under the influence of drugs, well,
you've done some crazy drugs, and you have seen some strange things with those drugs. Yeah. I think what you're saying, a lot of people might think, well, that's just crazy, but it's not when you look at the Bible,
mm-hmm.
because the Bible tells us that Satan is the ruler of this world. The Bible also says that the whole world lies in the power of the wicked one. And then when Jesus was tempted, Satan said, all of the governments, all of the kingdoms belong to me, and I
yeah.
give it to whoever I want.
Mm-hmm.
So there is definitely, going back to Paul's words, there's definitely supernatural forces at work.
Yeah.
Because, like I said, people may think you're crazy, but I listen to a lot of podcasts.
Yeah.
There are people that are not even Christian
mm-hmm.
at all.
Yeah.
And they just look at the facts, like what I was telling you earlier.
Yeah.
Facts are facts.
Mm-hmm.
Just admit, we live in a strange, supernatural world. Now, the word supernatural, you may have a different view of what that means.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it could just mean something you don't understand. Or
yeah.
it can mean you believe in Satan. But they understand something else is going on here. Because there is no way, like you said, there is no way people could orchestrate this stuff.
Yeah, there's and no communication.
Yeah.
Like, okay, we're all these studios are yeah. going to put out this movie with the same theme.
Yeah.
And we're all going to just, you know, we're going to have all these things that tie mm-hmm. into.
Yeah, there's a podcast I listen to. I laugh at him all the time because he always changes his voice. And it's like, what? Do these guys go through the Illuminati window and say, hey, you know, where should I put the all-seeing eye in this movie, you know?
Yeah, where can we put the 33? Where can
the 33,
we...
yeah. yeah. Yeah, like, I was watching, oh, it's disgusting, I would never watch it again. I watched it a while back before I changed my life, but there's a Netflix film, The Platform.
Oh, yeah, I was the one that you told that? You about it. Yeah,
yeah that's yeah. right, yeah, that's right. You're disgusting.
Well,
got
honestly,
me to watch that
it
movie.
It just, like, there was something about it that was...
You knew know, something was going on in the movie.
I mean,
huh?
It's clearly from the occult. I mean, they're quoting the Jesus, like, you know,
they are
eat my flesh and drink my blood. Mm-hmm. They're on platform
well, even,
33.
Yeah, I mean, they purposely yeah. show 33 back there.
Yeah,
I mean, it's not a coincidence. The camera's focusing on 33.
Yeah.
Which if you know anything about Freemasonry, that's the highest level in Freemasonry.
I mean, it's everything. We'll go back to that in a second, but I was just watching a commercial yesterday on, mm-hmm. on Hulu.
Yeah.
And it's like a car commercial. It's got
yeah.
like, I think Derek Jeter in it or something.
Yeah.
And like, you see the kids walking with their jerseys on. Who is the one kid in the center, like walking the closest to the camera? 33. It's everywhere.
Not a coincidence.
You keep an eye out for the 33s.
Yeah.
And, like, I know people say you'll recognize numbers because, you know, that's what your brain is doing is pattern recognition.
Yeah.
But no, I promise you, keep your eyes out for every movie.
Every Netflix original.
Yeah.
Guarantee you, you're going to find something. I was watching a movie with my wife, not a movie, a series with my wife, Love is Blind. It's a reality where these people are in this, you know, they don't see each other, but they're talking to
yeah,
each
yeah.
other. And supposedly they fall in love with this person, whatever. What on earth does that have to do with the occult?
Yeah.
Illuminati,
I mean, I can't
Zionism,
think of
whatever
yeah.
you want to call it. And you know, when we talk about the Illuminati, that's such a trigger word. Because anymore, Illuminati just means the whole thing. I mean,
yeah.
All secret society, Illuminati.
Yeah.
United Nations, Illuminati.
Yeah.
It's just a word. I love using that word, though, because it does, does get under people's skin.
Yeah.
It's kind of funny to see how they
it's
react.
It's a buzzword.
Yeah, it's fun. But I use it now more than I ever. I mean, in the past, I would say it.
Yeah.
Once in a while, to be careful. You know, I didn't want anybody to get stirred up. But now I just say it because we're seeing the unfolding
yeah.
of this happening
yeah.
fairly rapidly. But anyway, I was watching this show, and I'm like, There can't be anything on this show. Sure enough, the hostess has a necklace with, I believe it was not only a triangle, I believe it had the all-seeing eye.
Yeah.
On, I'm like, what is going on here?
Yeah.
So, and then what was it too? I think I don't know if I mentioned this before, but I know I may have told you about, I was at a theater by myself one day, and, you know, they always have these, you know, this is a production of this company and that company, and, you know, this is a branch of this, branch of that. I don't even understand half of the garbage they're telling you. I mean, so, but on the screen at one point, in the right-hand corner, it said something like a production of, or, you know, something of a company. The company's logo was 666, and you might, well, was it actually 666? No, it was occultic. It was three carbon molecules. Six, six, and six.
Yeah.
It is everywhere. And I remember hearing about other things, too, like the first computer was sold for $666, 66 cents. I used to think that was just a joke. No, it's real.
Yeah.
It's real. I was watching another Netflix film some months back, and there was a girl, like I may have said this before, so I keep repeating some of these things because it's fascinating.
Is it
like,
that one bedroom one or whatever?
No. Oh, that's another one. Don't get me started. I might mention that too. No, it was about it had nothing to do with the occult at all. It was just about a girl who was, I think she shot somebody in the classroom or something.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I mean, it was actually a cheesy show. I hated it. Yeah. I think I turned it off. But there was a scene where she came into the kitchen with a red sweatshirt on.
Yeah.
And she sat in the kitchen, turned around, and right there, big white numbers, 666.
Yeah.
And I'm like, what is going on here? Obviously, yeah. I mean, I knew what was going on at that point, and I watched a ghost story.
Yeah. Oh, I remember watching that with you. You see the all-seeing eye.
Yeah, he jumped off that building, and right there in the background, you see the skyscraper.
Yeah, all-seeing eye on it. I was just telling you about The Knowing, too. Another movie that was just featured on Hulu. Mm-hmm. And you watch it, and, like, I remember when that movie came out a few years back. I mean, it's got Nicolas Cage. It's, like, super corny.
What was the name of that?
The Knowing.
The Knowing. Oh, I remember.
And like, it's about the kid that like writes and all this stuff, and mm-hmm. like, you know, he's telling all the the future events, you know, mm-hmm. and like, oh, here's where the future ends. Here's where the end of the world is, and you know, I can't remember exactly the story, but like, you know, the sun is shining in one mm-hmm. in one scene, and you see it makes a perfect pyramid out of the sun rays.
Yes.
And then like he's looking at these letters, you know, these initials, and he's mm-hmm. like, E-E, what is E-E? And I'm like, E-E is 33.
Yes.
It's 33. It's, yes. I mean,
it's like, everywhere.
Like,
exactly.
So, I mean, this stuff is just everywhere. And like, what does the 33, I mean, like,
I think there was some movie on Tubi, which has mostly B movies, but they do have some good stuff if you dig down. Like, there was one cheesy movie. It was called 11-11-11.
Huh. I think I might have seen
it. I mean, like it was written like a date, 11-11-11. 33. People who hear this for the first time, they think, oh, you're just seeing things, right? But, yeah. I mean, you're seeing it everywhere.
Yeah.
And I can just go on and on.
I guess, like, what is the... like, I don't want to go too far into it, but like the significance of like 33 is that Jesus was 33 years old.
I know. That's
when he ascended.
That's another, it's endless, isn't it?
You got 33 vertebrae in your spine.
Mm-hmm.
There's like,
it has to do with
the Kundalini,
sacred geometry,
yeah.
Things that we don't understand.
Yeah, plus the 3 + 3 = 6 is the day of the day that man was made, or mm-hmm. like there's
a lot of
and when you look at the 3 and the 3, what you're seeing is two triangles, two pointed mm-hmm. figures. So yeah. And then when you transpose them, you see the what they would call the Star of David or the Seal of Solomon. So it's actually the 33 ties very directly into the symbol that is the what we would call the Star of David. Yeah. And like it's...
And there's... Yeah. That, you know, man, I could just go on and on about the movies and everything that we're talking about. And I like know. You said, there is a connection there between Jesus, the 33, you know,
yeah.
when he died and all of that. There is a connection there because in theosophy, as we said, Jesus is very important.
Mm-hmm.
It all ties. It's like they took the Bible,
mm-hmm.
they took the literal Jesus and applied it to their theosophy. It wasn't the other way around.
And what it really is Gnosticism.
Yeah, Gnosticism you can see was showing up even in the Bible.
Well, that's what the whole first John was directed specifically at
to the Gnostics,
mm-hmm. that were coming up inside of the congregations yeah. was like, no, you're so wrong. Like Jesus came in the flesh.
Mm-hmm.
Anyone who says that he didn't, that's the Antichrist. Yeah. And then you see that this small sect of Christianity, Gnosticism, like, it almost disappeared. Like, it was so out there and weird mm-hmm. for a while. And then, like, now it's, like, everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
It's everywhere. So that, it's very odd.
Yeah, and so when I began to wake up, and I've read this before. I think maybe you're the one that... mentioned this, that you read it somewhere, that when you wake up to what's going on in the world, and it has nothing to do with Christianity,
mm-hmm.
you begin to see things that you never seen before.
Yeah.
Like in music, movies, everywhere. It's like yesterday, you know, I went to the movie theater. I watched A Quiet Place 2. You know how they always show all the previews and everything?
Yeah.
It's just not the same anymore. You can see through all of the
yeah.
the propaganda, how they're trying to mold your mind. I mean, more Marvel movies and all this nonsense. But anyway, yeah, you begin to open your mind and you see things. I mean, and it's everywhere. I always talk about these things because I'm still fascinated by it. These yeah. music groups. I think you're the one that told me, again, that when you wake up, you'll begin to look at lyrics differently.
Yeah, yeah.
And you realize, whoa, that's what they're singing about.
It's like you had these, like, it's like you had the rose-colored glasses on, and then mm-hmm. you take them off, and what you just see this pattern that reoccurs everywhere in your music that, like, you never saw before.
Yes. Almost all of my groups, you yeah. know, most of my groups are progressive rock and progressive metal, especially in progressive music. Just about every group I listen to.
Mm-hmm.
has a song or many songs about the New World Order.
Yeah.
And how it's all occultic. And I didn't realize that until one day, as another example, you know, my favorite groups have always been Rush, Queensrÿche, yeah. right? This album, I think it had a huge impact on me. I mean, I was already awake, but when I heard... And I've listened to this album 100 times. I mean, even as a younger person, I would listen to this album, a Queensrÿche album called The Warning. And mm-hmm. I just thought, what a weird story. Just yeah. a crazy story, fictional thing. Didn't really look at the lyrics. And even if I did, I still wouldn't know what he was talking about. But once I awakened, one day I was at work, and I was playing this Queensrÿche, The Warning album. And I'm like, what the heck? I mean, instantly I'm like, this song is about what's happening now.
Yeah.
In fact, the first song on the album is about people like me, people yeah. like you. It is about how people like you and I, and we're not special, there's many people like this. They're awake. And that song even says they could see the signs and the symbols and basically... You don't know at what point it's going to be your last warning mm-hmm. for what is to come.
Yeah.
And then as you listen to the album, the next song, I believe, is called The Enforcer or something. And
I mean, like, you can't even go into all the lyrics, but I've read the lyrics for that album. And it's yeah. like, it's
unforgettable, isn't it?
It may be somebody could easily pass off what you're saying right now just as like, oh, it says this one thing. No, yeah. it's like... There's a lot of stuff in there.
Every song there's is even, a progression.
He says, "Born under Saturn," doesn't he?
Oh yeah. I want to get into that. Yeah, that's so, where I want to get into that.
Yeah, yeah.
That line in itself, but I'm going to mention that again here in just a minute. But
yeah.
Yeah, it's funny you said that because that ties in with where I originally was going to go with our conversation.
Yeah, yeah.
But we got off, but that's all right, because this all ties in. Yeah, the second song, then, is about how the enforcers are now taking over the world. And the chorus, they even say, the master of nations is revealed. So there comes a point in time when the nations, the master of who's behind all this plan, is finally revealed.
Yeah.
And then as you continue listening to the album, you come across a song called No Sanctuary. And I can go, boy, this is getting me into other groups as well, but
yeah,
No Sanctuary is about how once they take over, you're going to have no place to find rest. No spiritual aspect in life, because they believe they have the truth, you know, the theosophy, the ones behind this, you know, they believe that's true. So in this song, it's basically, it even says, you're going to be crying and screaming, but there is no sanctuary for you. It's too late. It's too late to seek spiritual things, right?
Yeah.
So anyway, the whole album, when you listen to it all, it is about the supernatural aspect of what's going on.
Yeah.
Now, someone might say, well, like you said, people listen to it and they just pass it off. I'm sure they think I'm crazy even talking about it. But it's when you see this everywhere.
Yeah.
So, like, you take Rush album. What made them famous? 2112.
Yeah.
Why is it 2112?
Because,
2112 is 33 in gematria.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, you got your 21.
I mean, it's 2112, but why is it called 2112?
And that's what's weird is that there is a movie that was put out. It's a cheesy film. Only reason why I watched it is to see the occultic, esoteric stuff. Yeah. Remember in 2012, people were talking about the end of the world.
Yeah.
Oh, the Mayan calendar ended. Mm-hmm. So you got all these people talking about the literal end of the world.
Yeah.
And that's what the controllers want you to believe, right?
Yeah.
It's just nonsense.
Yeah.
Well, you can study. These things are real. And this is what makes reality so weird. The Mayan calendar ended on 2012 because, according to their cycles, that was the beginning. That was the end of the old world.
Yeah.
And the new world was about to build itself. Well, what's interesting about that is later on I watched a video. I think you sent it to me. Remember that rabbi? That man who claimed to be the Moshiach the Messiah?
You're talking about...
what's his name?
Okay, so like I'm not exactly sure about all of that, but yeah, I do...
I'm not saying that he is
Joseph
that.
Gregory Hallett.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And he has nothing to do with that movie.
Yeah, yeah.
And I'm not even saying that...
But when he did say that the signal of the end of the new age, or the beginning of the new age, was...
was in 2012.
Yeah.
Okay. So, Rush album... you had 2112, right?
Mm-hmm.
So the 12, end of the old world. Well, it's not a coincidence that the year 2021, now, starting in January, it was the beginning of the Great Reset for the New World Order.
Yeah.
People might think that's crazy. I've told people everywhere. I have spread the message everywhere. Just look up COVID-19 and the Great Reset. It takes you to the World Economic Forum, and it's everywhere. I mean... you can even read on Bloomberg. You can read on Scientific America, whatever.
Yeah.
They even have articles that talk about the New World Order and how that's where we're heading.
Yeah.
So, 2112. Here, this album was made, 1976 or something? 75? I can't remember. But
yeah.
That whole album, you thought was just this fictional story about how people... how the controllers took away the music and they no longer had... They didn't even know what a guitar was and all this stuff. It's because it's an allegorical song. But that entire song is about the New World Order. And that's how it concludes, that they have taken over the world.
Yeah.
And in that song, the Temples of Syrinx, it's about the high priests.
Yeah.
And how they control things. And what's weird is, remember the line in that song?
These computers.
Yes.
Is that the one you're talking about? Yeah.
Computers. They control the world through their computers.
Fill our hollowed halls.
The hollowed halls.
Yeah.
Written in the 70s. honestly, did the average person even
really think about computers
all that much?
Yeah.
No. Yet that album is completely about the controllers and what's happening.
Yeah.
And I mean, I'm talking. I listen to some groups that don't sing about serious things as well. Yeah. Like there's a song called or a group called Work of Art.
Yeah.
Just more like radio type rock, right?
Yeah.
Sure enough, they have a song called Time Machine, and that's what it's about.
Yeah.
It's about the controllers.
This stuff about the New World Order, which is just a government that supersedes all other governments, that is headed by a religious type of group, you know?
It's all religion is our problem today.
And this is what it reminds me. I'm just going to read the whole thing because it's real short, but like Psalms 2. You read this thing is, why do the nations rage and the peoples plot in vain? The kings of the earth set themselves and the rulers take counsel together against the Lord and against his anointed, saying, let us burst their bonds apart and cast away their cords from us. He who sits in the heavens laughs. The Lord holds them in derision. Then he will speak to them in his wrath and terrify them in his fury, saying, as for me, I have set my king on Zion, my holy hill. I will tell of the decree. The Lord said to me, you are my son. Today I have begotten you. Ask of me, and I will make the nations your heritage and the ends of the earth your possession. You shall break them with a rod of iron and dash them in pieces like a potter's vessel. Now therefore, O kings, be wise. Be warned, O rulers of the earth. Serve the Lord with fear and rejoice with trembling. Kiss the Son, lest he be angry and you perish in the way. For his wrath is quickly kindled. Blessed are all those who take refuge in him. So you see that this is a prophecy.
And it's a conspiracy.
And it's a conspiracy.
That's what it's telling you there.
Yeah. Yeah.
They act as one.
Yeah.
Against God and against his anointing.
They plot together.
They plot.
And counsel together against against his anointed one.
I like the way one channel that I listen to, it's called Truth Unedited, and he's a, you know, he's a Bible believer, believes in God, Christ, all of that. And I'm not saying I run with everything that everybody says. I don't. But I listen to many podcasts, and he actually made a good point. If you don't believe in conspiracy, you're asleep.
Yeah.
And you don't really understand the Bible or even believe it because Satan is supernatural.
Yeah.
And he is, you just read it, working. Yeah. If you don't believe that they're working as one against God, then your view of
and if someone wants to shut it down, what is that in Proverbs? He says that it's a fool who shuts down a matter before hearing it out.
Yes.
So you would be very foolish before hearing out all the evidence to the contrary of what you believe. Like if you are very much against it, you'd be a fool to not just at least hear what somebody has to say, to actually do some of this research for yourself, because what you'll find is that it would be very hard to deny.
Yeah. And I like what you said, and I totally agree, and I think most Christians do agree, that what's going on here is not a president or a world leader or some producer in Hollywood saying, hey, you know, we got to make this all fit, this fakery movie out here. And I need to know, should I put the 666 here? And I don't believe groups like Queensryche are like, let's write this awesome stuff, you know, and have all these details. Yeah. And it all is the same, too. I mean, it all, like I said, there's so many musicians that talk about this, the same thing over and over again. Supernatural forces are at work.
Yeah.
And you begin to see that everywhere.
Yeah.
And, you know, I think this might be a good spot to stop this podcast right now. Well,
I know you had some other stuff that you wanted to talk about.
Here's why, because I think a good way of ending this before getting into the next part, because, you know, originally I wanted to talk about kind of fascinating thing, you know how you found Christ and how I was looking for Satan. What did I find? See, we talked about what you found. Well, you mentioned something in that Queensryche album that really hit me hard, because I'm like, I already knew some of this stuff. Yeah. And now I'm hearing it in the song. So what's going on?
It's that same deal where you start connecting puzzle pieces.
Yes, again. It's like we've said before, the Great Awakening is happening now, and that's even an Eastern thought.
Yeah.
The Great Awakening. People are beginning to see that our lives are not normal. Mm-hmm. They are not natural. Everything we do is controlled. We think we're free. No, we're not. We have never been free as human beings. Never. Yeah. Especially nowadays. It's like we can't even escape this matrix that we're in. But in that, when I was listening to that album, they have a song called Child of Fire.
Yeah.
And it mentions, the first line is like, born under the darkness of Saturn's rings.
Yeah.
I heard that and I'm like, oh my God, what?
Yeah.
This, I mean, I remember just being like, what? This is fascinating.
Yeah.
Why are they telling us this?
Yeah.
And so that's where I want to take us the next time we get together. Okay. Because it's the rabbit hole.
Just fascinated
that
you.
I was in.
Yeah.
So we'll talk about that next time.
Okay. Sounds good. All right, guys. Well, thank you very much. We appreciate it.
Because that's a testament to me being alive. I could have died. I mean, the devil tried and tried, but no, the Lord let me ride. Like a bike with the pedals on the side. I use my shovel for my pride. That's the level, because it's levels to this. Pick a side, and if you faithful, you gonna earn a medal for this. Too many wanna sell out. Me and so many fell out. It's forgiveness for us sinners. Messiah got plenty bailouts. Spells and curses in the English language. The modern world is tainted. Stained glass sanctuaries, the devil painted. The saints are buried in temporary arrangements. Another exodus for God's chosen and judgment for the nation.